name is Renaldi Wijaya. I'm from English Literature B 2019 with the student number 19140206 44. Okay, and then I'm gonna reviewing about cultural studies chapter 12 that with the title psychoanalytic approaches to cultural and the self. Okay, we're going to the review. So in this chapter we know that the relationship between cultural theory and psychoanalytic theory is a complex one. There are clear affinities in as far as both see social life as essentially about meaning and impulses we need for interpretation. The relationship becomes strained over two themes. First, psychoanalysis in its traditional form at least has tended to focus on the pathologies of the individual rather than on collective phenomena. And secondly, there is tendency toward psychological and biological reductionism in much psychoanalytic thought. Moves that have been made by some psychoanalytic thinkers aimed at breaking down these barriers mark out one of the major achievements of 20th century cultural theory. This work has now reached the stage where it sometimes seems impossible to delineate certain psychoanalytic theories from cultural theory more broadly confused. Before we can discuss these more recent theories, we need first to review of the work of the founder of psychoanalysis, Sigmund Freud. Sigmund Freud was an Australian neurologist and the founder of psychoanalysis in a clinical method for treating psychopathology thought through dialogue between a patient and psychoanalyst. Freud was born to Galician Jewish parents in the Moravian town of Freiburg, in Australian Empire. Freud challenged the assumption that the self was merely what can be seen on the surface. He argued that identity, personality, and mental function were far more complex than anyone had previously imagined. First, he claimed that there was a basic split between the conscious mind and hidden unconscious mind. In Freud's understanding, the self was very much about sexuality, instinct, and pleasure. According to his theory of the pleasure principle, they then become buried or repressed in the unconscious, where they will sometimes generate neurosis, preferences of senses, and psychic pathologies. And then we go to post-Freudian theories of self and society. Psychoanalytic theory has not stood still since Freud died. In many ways, civilization and its discontents set the scene for this shift, with interest in macro-sociological issues and the links between psych pathology and modernity. After that, we going to the Frankfurt School. The Frankfurt School was a school of social theory and critical philosophy, associated with the Institute for Social Research at Goethe University, Frankfurt. In sociology and political philosophy, the term critical theory described the Western Marxist philosophy of the Frankfurt School, which was developed in Germany in 1930s and draws on the ideas of Karl Marx and Sigmund Freud. And there are Jacques Lacan. For those influenced by structuralism, post-structuralism, and discourse analysis, Jacques Lacan's in the 1977, writing from the 1975s and 76, are the keys to theorizing the association of culture and psychoanalysis. Of one of the reasons for that is has his broadly post-structural approach shift responsibility for the construction on the self away from biological drive as advocated by Freud toward language and culture. And in this era there is post-Lacanian psychoanalytic cultural theory. By combining psychoanalytic theories of the self with structuralist understandings of the culture, Lacan's work has exerted a distinctive impact on cultural studies and cultural theory, obviously, especially in the area of psychoanalytic feminism and literary and film criticism. And there are postmodern psychoanalytic cultural theory as we move from past structural toward postmodern psychoanalytic theory. More and more attention is given to such issues of desire and pleasure alongside attacks on the concept of the unitary subject as the repository of desire. And I think that's all for me. Thank you.